Hi, everyone, and welcome. In this episode, we are counting down the top six things we did while we were in Ambergris Key, Belize. And this isn't just some travel guide where people tell you what might be good. We actually did it. We're going to show you all the craziness and fun right here. Let's get to it. We've got a lot of adventure to show you on and around Ambergris Key. From Houston, we flew into Belize City, and from there caught a Tropicair flight over to Ambergris Key, where we'd be staying for the week. So you know if we're going somewhere, we gotta try to find something weird to do, and man, did Ambergris Key deliver. In San Pedro, they have what's called the chicken drop, where you're gambling on chicken poop. So they have this big board on the beach with a fence around it and 100 numbers on the floor. You purchase your tickets, and if the chicken poops on your number, you win. I shit you not.
To blow that chicken's butt. All right? So, are you ready? Start swinging, start swinging. Start swinging! Go up!
Oh my God!
Up and down, up and down. Security assistance! Blow that! Ladies and gentlemen, first round is on the way. $100 on the line. Let's get it.
On Ambergris Key, the most fun method of transportation is by far the golf cart. So we're gonna fire that baby up and get out and explore the island. We wanted some lunch and we found out there was a cool little place near us called the Truck Stop, which is a funky little gathering of food trucks around a seating area, kind of like an island food court, I guess. They have a stage, so I guess they have bands there on some days or maybe in the evening. There was no band that day, so we had to make our own entertainment.
Okay, so hopefully in a couple minutes we'll see Shakira walking out.
Oh baby, when you talk like that.
Just waiting here patiently.
Like, look, there's her hair.
Having a golf cart allowed us to get out and explore a lot, and that leads right into number four, Secret Beach. It was a bumpy ride over there in the golf cart. We had fun with it, but it was really rattle your teeth bumpy, and it was a pretty long ride over there. But it was totally worth it. Secret Beach is a super cool little area. There are a few different restaurants there, and most of them have picnic tables out on the water where you can hang out and eat and have drinks. There was a good-sized crowd, but it wasn't packed, so it was perfect. And we ran into some fun people from our dive boat the day before. It was a lot of fun, definitely worth checking out. That evening, we watched a gorgeous sunset melt into the horizon. It was a pretty amazing day. Next, we check out Holchan Marine Reserve and Shark Ray Alley. I've snorkeled there a couple times, and it's a lot of fun. There are a ton of nurse sharks, turtles, and stingrays. It's especially fun to see the nurse sharks. I haven't done a dive on Shark Ray Alley, and Maria hadn't been to either one, so we were pretty excited about the trip where we would dive Shark Ray Alley and then snorkel in Holchan. The current was ripping pretty good on the Shark Ray Alley dive, and it's a shallow dive anyway. My max depth was 28 feet, so it made the dive challenging. Without the current, it probably would have been a more relaxing dive, but even without the current, I think that snorkeling it was just about as good as diving it. But if you go to Belize, definitely check out Holchan and Shark Ray Alley. At number two, the Great Blue Hole. If you're a diver and you're going to Belize, you're probably considering diving the Blue Hole if you haven't done it before. If you've heard of the Blue Hole, you've probably heard a lot of different opinions on it. Deciding what to include in your vacation can be tough. There's a limited amount of money and time on vacation. But for us, it came down to one thing. You never know what it's like until you do it. So here are the facts about our trip to the Blue Hole. It was a long ride out there, about 2.5 hours each way from Ambergris Key. It was a fairly expensive trip. It was about $300 per person, but we did get three dives out of that, and it was a full day trip, including lunch, and we got to do some exploring on Half Moon Key. So after the briefing, we got geared up and got ready to dive the Great Blue Hole. As far as the actual dive itself, we got into the water, swam down a gentle slope to the edge of the hole. After that, we started our descent to 130 feet. On the long and creepy descent to 130 feet, the only marine life we saw were three horse-eyed jacks. At 130 feet, we leveled off and prepared to swim into the ledge with the huge stalactites. As you hover there, probably deeper than you've ever been diving, you look down and you see blackness and wonder how far it goes. So we swam through this otherworldly crevice in the rock, passing behind huge stalactites, seeing just a hint of the light far above and complete darkness below. I gotta say, this is one of the most disorienting dives I've ever been on. Being on that vertical wall and looking straight up and then looking straight down into nothingness was just amazing. I've had similar experiences on wall dives, but this is absolutely at another level. So after all the pros and cons, and after the experience of actually doing it, how was the blue hole? For me, I love diving, and I love just being underwater. One of our recent dive trips, a dive guide was asking what dive site we wanted to go to. One of the women on the boat said, any of them that are underwater. Every dive has something amazing for me. Whether it's big stuff, like sharks or eagle rays, or small stuff, like a little sharp-nosed puffer looking up at me, I learn something new or have a new experience nearly every dive. And that's how I feel about the blue hole. Was it by far the most amazing dive I've ever done? Probably not. Was it a fantastic experience that I can talk about and say, I've done that? Yes. And that's what adventure means to me. So bottom line, I'm definitely glad I did it. And that brings us to number one. There were so many sharks. We'll do an entire episode on how the shark diving was on this trip, so we won't show that now, but subscribe to get notified when that comes out. You're not going to want to miss it.